Just barely 3 months after the creation of Hype House, and things have already started falling apart in the Los Angeles home for TikTok content creators. In a recent video on YouTube, Hype House co-founder Daisy Keach shared what really went down in the Hype House. In this video, we're going to be looking at what she said and also uncovering some truths that she didn't want to say in order to get to the bottom of the matter. If it's your first time here, please like this video and subscribe. Also, turn on the bell notification so you get notified when we drop a new video. And with that out of the way, let's get straight into the video. The whole story revolves around Daisy Keach and Thomas Petru. Thomas is known as the manager of the Hype House and is credited with being the co-founder of the group, alongside 17-year-old Chase Hudson, also known as Little Huddy, sidelining Daisy. So recently, Keach started voicing out a desire to be seen and regarded as a co-founder too. According to her, she deserved to be a co-founder, as she was one of the people to bring up the idea, which is the Hype House. However, we were not privy to this information until the fallout was complete. Daisy started out her video by explaining her friendship with Thomas. She explained that they became friends after he was let go from Team 10, a similar group owned by Jake Paul, which is now defunct. After he was let go from the team, she hired him to be her full-time photographer and editor. However, their work relationship was quite informal. She mentioned that they both hung out almost every day, told each other everything, and she even considered him her best friend. She further mentioned that it was around this time that Thomas started talking about ideas for the Hype House, of course, trying to create something similar to Team 10. Petru, being a photographer, also had a photo shoot with Hudson. It was during this period that the main creators of the Hype House met and connected with each other. There were 5 creators in total. These 5 creators became fast friends, and talk about starting the collab house swung into full gear, mainly because, at that time, Hudson didn't have a place to stay. He was staying in an Airbnb rental in Los Angeles. After agreeing that they were going to do this, the creators then started searching for houses to rent on Zillow, and they did this all together. When they eventually found the place that is now known as the Hype House, all of them put their money together to pay for the deposit. Daisy said that she and Hudson were the biggest contributors to the project, as they both put in $18,000, while Thomas only put in $5,000, leaving the remaining 2 creators to contribute the rest together. They all then moved into the space and started creating social media buzz for the Hype House. As you would expect, they gained buzz almost immediately. It didn't take too long for everyone to want to get an interview, including Taylor Lorenz of the New York Times. And this is where things went south. Daisy mentioned that the interview they had with Taylor was the first in-person interaction she had ever had with the press. And being a naturally reserved and introverted person, she was feeling intimidated throughout the interview. She had assumed that her friends would acknowledge her efforts in creating the house, but she recalls that they completely took over the interview while she remained silent. In her own words, "Being 20 years old and not having a manager there with me like Chase had, and I had no idea how to speak up and say that I was a co-founder. I know that Chase's manager was, like, really pushing him to speak up and make it known that he was a co-founder, which I think is very important. It's very smart of her, and I even wish that I had someone telling me to get that recognition." Taylor has also come out to the public to collaborate Daisy's story, explaining that it can be very intimidating to speak with reporters, especially when it's your first time and you're so young. Taylor further mentioned in an interview with Insider that she had been careful to review the evidence provided her. These were emails and text messages showing that Hudson and Petru discussed the idea of creating a TikTok collab house before they told Daisy about it. Daisy never tried to dispute this during or after the interview, until a month and a half later when she sent her lawyer to Taylor to request a correction to the story. To this date, neither the New York Times nor the Insider has corrected their stories, even though both of these news outlets have received a request to do so. Thomas and Chase were interviewed by Tom Ward. And in this interview, the pair mentioned that they regard themselves as the co-founders because they were the ones who brought the group into existence. After this interview, Daisy said she reached out to Thomas and told him that it was messed up that they didn't give any other person credit. Daisy was not only just fighting for herself to be regarded as a co-founder, but also the other two creators as well. She mentioned that after the conversation, she felt like they had come to a resolution and the matter was settled. However, in future interviews and coverages of the group, the remaining three creators were still regarded and looked at as mere members. On social media, both Thomas and Hudson were keeping up with the narrative that they were the only co-founders, even after telling her during their heart-to-heart that it merely skipped his mind because she wasn't at the interviews. It was then that she began to notice all of Thomas's dubious ways. First off, the business email for the Hype House was tied to Thomas's personal mail, and he would not release the access to anyone else. The rest of the crew didn't know much about the brand deals. He claimed that all of the brands were only offering products to give them exposure, and they weren't paid. He claimed that they had made no money yet, but in the same breath, he was talking about buying a new Tesla and rocking an $8,000 Cartier bracelet. Thomas was also the one who controlled the group's public image, as he was the one handling all of their social media accounts. She further explained that he loved to have power and tell people what to do, making the house feel like a dictatorship. She talked about one event when one of the creators was denied an opportunity to meet with the press, and Thomas ended the conversation by saying, "Well, it's not your decision, because I make all the decisions around here." She also mentioned that Thomas started to phase her out of the group by forgetting to tell her about important dates, and when asked by her lawyer and manager, Thomas had this to say about Daisy, "You know what? I'm just more of a businessman. And girls like Daisy, she's just another hot Instagram model with a shelf life." After this, she started to rethink her place in the group. She explained how she tried to file applications to get their name registered with the U.S. Patent and Trademark Office so no one would steal their name and prevent them from selling merch. She also said she wanted every member of the group to have partial ownership to create a structure for the business. But Thomas ignored all she said. The last straw was when she came home to a video shoot. Thomas said that he told the whole group about the shoot via text, but he conveniently forgot to tell Daisy, and even the landlord. He tried to defend it by saying that the house had nothing to do with the brand, Hype House. Wow, Thomas. But after that, they both unfollowed each other on all social media platforms, and that was it. Of course, Thomas didn't take lightly to the video she posted, posting on his Instagram status, "Lies on lies on lies," apparently referring to Daisy. Well, for now, that's all we know, folks. Don't forget to like the video, subscribe, and turn on that bell notification so you get notified when we drop a new video.